Coming up, we take an early look at how the Office 365 Security and Compliance Center helps you fulfill regulatory data subject requests for personal information held in Office 365. GDPR mandates that individuals in the European Union have the right to access the personal data held on them, as well as the ability to correct or erase and even transport their data records to a different location. Responding to data subject requests in Security and Compliance Center makes it easier for you to pinpoint relevant Office 365 data in a way that's both effective and efficient. As you can see, you get to GDPR capabilities directly in Security and Compliance Center under the new Data Privacy tab. Or you can get to them via the Service Trust platform, which is the central portal for compliance-related resources for Microsoft services. In the Service Trust portal, you navigate to Privacy, which gives you the ability to manage data subject requests across all commercial Microsoft services. If your request is related to content created in Office 365, such as Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive, and others, you can easily navigate to Security and Compliance Center from here to get started. Once you are in the Security and Compliance Center, you can manage data subject requests related to Office 365 data. In this tab, we give you an aggregated dashboard that summarizes the key resources related to GDPR. Here, you can get links to more information to familiarize yourself with GDPR and the security and compliance features available in Office 365. Smart reports give you insights to help you track progress against your GDPR compliance goals. For example, if you are already using data governance and classified your data using labels, then you will be able to see the top 5 classification labels and usage trends for your organization. You can learn more about information protection through classification and labeling on our recent Mechanics show. Going back to our dashboard, you can also see insights where data loss prevention has picked up on GDPR-sensitive data. We also show insights on targeted users based on our built-in threat intelligence, which helps you make decisions on hardening your environment and safeguarding your users using threat policies. At the top of the dashboard, you can see a list of active and closed data subject requests over the past 60 days. All of these intelligent insights are designed to help your organization with GDPR. Now, let me walk you through how to fulfill a data subject request from initiating the search, filtering down your results, and reviewing the data before you export the final report. To get started, I just need to select DSRs on the left. Here, you see both your active and closed DSR cases, again in one view, but in more detail. Now, to create a new DSR case, I'll click here. This will guide me through the process you need to start by giving the DSR case a name. Now, I'll add a description. Under the request details, enter the name of the data subject, which is the person's first and last name. You get a confirmation screen and hit save. This initiates the search process. So this may take a moment depending on the amount of content that is being searched. If you're familiar with eDiscovery, in the background, DSR uses the same technology as our eDiscovery content search capabilities. Once you have the search results, you can then refine your data set further. By selecting Add Conditions, I can refine my search results. In this case, I'm going to select keywords and compliance tags, which map to any labels that you may have set up. Now I search for a GDPR sensitive type, such as France social security number. Next, you can also scope down your data set by modifying locations. You can select specific Office 365 apps, such as Exchange, SharePoint, Microsoft Teams, or To Do and others. I'm going to turn off Exchange public folders from being searched. Finally, after you've refined your data, you can export it. Results are packaged up into a PST for emails or as document types. Once you've accessed the exported data, you can determine which data is appropriate to provide to the requesting data subject. So, that was a quick overview of the new data subject request capability in Office 365. We have more capabilities coming in the future. And if there are specific things that you would like to see, please keep giving us feedback by selecting feedback in the Security and Compliance Center. You can learn more at the link shown. Thanks for watching.